Hey guys, welcome to my channel. This is actually my first video on this channel, and if you guys see this video, make sure that you subscribe, make sure that you like this video, and make sure that you watch till the end. So in today's video, I'm gonna be sharing with you guys 10 ideas, or should I say YouTube niche, that I think are fast growing. And I think if you really want to hop onto this YouTube bus and you want your channel to blow up sooner and you want the YouTube algorithm to pick up your channel faster, these are the ideas that I think are fast growing. I'm sure you guys will really agree with me that these days makeup channels, vlog channels are really having a hard time to pick up, simply because if you look at YouTube, that a lot of videos which are doing that, there are a lot of vlogs, there are a lot of makeup, basically there are a lot of videos out there to meet the demand of people who want to watch those videos. There are a lot of beauty gurus, so most people prefer to watch those beauty gurus than to watch very new channels which are just starting. Especially as Africans, I feel like a lot of niches, you know, when you search on YouTube, for example, when it comes to cooking channels, there are very few cooking channels in Africa, especially Southern Africa, and we end up, you know, subscribing to channels which we don't relate to. So those are the kind of niches which you are supposed to be focusing on, and in this video I'm gonna be listing them. And make sure that you take notes, and if you want to start a YouTube channel, make sure that you decide which one goes along with your passion. You don't want to just pick up and jump in a bus for something that you have no passion whatsoever about. So the first niche which I think is gonna blow up, it's already blowing up and the videos are already doing well, and if you get on YouTube, there are really few videos, especially when it comes to us African YouTubers, we tend to pick up these niches so late when they are already saturated. So the first one is manifesting. Yes, I said manifesting, and honestly speaking, I don't know where people lived before. It's like people now are realizing the power of manifesting your dream, the power of writing down, the power of talking to the universe. And if you go on Twitter right now, there are a lot of those candle emojis. Everyone want to know, is it working? Everyone want to explore the power of attraction. Everyone want to see a testimony out there of people saying, yo, I did this and this, it worked. Everyone want to be taken on a journey for doing that. So if you really get on YouTube, there are a lot of channels which are already doing that, but there are very few African channels which are doing that. If you don't know other videos that you can do surrounding those topics, you can actually get on YouTube, find a YouTuber who is doing a similar thing and study their channel, see the type of content they are putting out, and then you can decide whether it's something which is like worth exploring, how stretchable it is. I'm talking long term. Are you not gonna get stuck with no content, you know? The second niche that I want to talk about is making money online. These days people are lazy to go to work. There is this generation which just want to sit home and get money, as they should, as we should, you know. We want to know how we can make extra money online, and there are really few information. For example, if you get on the internet, you see a lot of Americans explaining things like dropshipping, investing, you know, things that sometimes they are not really applicable to. It will really be interesting to see people tapping on that and going all along and showing people options of making money online, how you can do it in Africa, apps that you can use, apps that are, you know, apps that you can use in Africa, and options. And sometimes you don't really have to be having knowledge on that. You can actually start a YouTube channel, you know, growing with people, saying my journey to be a millionaire, for example, surround it around that, and then you go out there, you explore this app with people, you show people that, you know, I tried this app, it literally does not work, I tried this app, it works. You don't have to be a millionaire to teach people about making money online, and you won't be teaching them if you don't know anything. You'll be experiencing with them, which most people want to really know, is it possible, is it doable? I want to see someone starting from scratch and doing it. That is the type of the content that people want to see nowadays, and I feel like that is a very good niche to tap onto. And the second niche, which is very relatable to the one that I just said, is teaching people about how to grow on YouTube. Trust me when I say, a lot of people have now realized the amount of opportunities that you can get just from being a YouTuber. You can actually start your brand based on like your YouTube subscribers, whatever you want to sell, you can start from your YouTube platform. So a lot of people have seen how how important having a YouTube is for a business and for the future, since now everything is surrounded around social media and a lot of people are really trying to get on that bus. They want that piece of pie, and it's hard because more and more people are getting onto YouTube and the algorithm is not as forgiving, and it's very, very hard to blow up as a channel or for YouTube algorithm to pick you up. And I feel like you can actually start a channel and actually do research. If you already have a channel, if you already know how to do it, you can actually tell people how to blow up, how to upload your content, the apps that you can use, how to get monetized, how to attract new subscribers, that type of content. I'm telling you, a lot of people are really, really getting a lot of views from that. Even I've seen, like, with some channels which are really not focusing on that, once they get monetized, there's this video that people like doing, like, how I managed to get monetized, how did I do it, how I managed to get my 4,000 watch hours. And if you really, really pay attention to those videos, you'll see that that person really got a lot of views on that videos, because everyone wants to know how did they do it. You know, how did you get there? We started together and you managed to get monetized. Why not me? You know, how did you do it? That type of content, I promise you, it's a very good niche, and a lot of people are really, really, really getting a lot of views from them. And you guys know that views equals money. The other niche that I want to talk about is actually how to start a business. Since the pandemic and since the whole corona thing, and since people are now seeing that it's actually possible to be a millionaire before you actually are 30 years, I think it's a very good idea to start a channel around those ideas of how you can start your business, how you can be your own boss, and starting a business from scratch, the apps that you can use, how to get funding, how to utilize your money, mistakes to avoid, anything that has to do with business. People want to know, people want to start businesses, and it's really hard. So if you are someone who is running a business and who is very successful and you don't mind sharing, I think it will be a very, very good idea to hop onto YouTube and start something around those niche, because most of the time we rely on information from, you know, American business owners, and sometimes the type of the information that they're sharing is not really applicable to us, looking at our target market, our population, our demand, and everything, and the apps that we can use. I've already said that so many times, so I feel like if we can have someone who is very relatable, I'm not saying they're not there, they're already there, but there is still more demand. You want someone you can connect with. I feel like there is still a lot of a gap that can be filled. And as I've already said, you don't need to have a business to do a YouTube about business. You can actually start with people, tell people, yo, I'm starting this business thing, work with me, and then after a month you can give an update, the mistake that I made, the progress, the apps that helped me, how did I go about it, and people will be very, very interested to know about it. I feel that is a very, very important thing. The other niche that I also want to talk about is self-care. I feel like for a very, very long time, Africans and us black people, we didn't embrace a luxurious life, and I feel like people now are seeing that, you know what, we have to embrace this life unapologetically, and we have to do it, you know, live it, travel, do whatever you want. Black child, you can do it, it's possible. And I feel like a niche around self-care is a very, very important niche. There are a lot of people who are doing this, and I feel like there is still more demand in YouTube. So if you can hop on YouTube, film videos about self-care, bridge self-care, you know, getting massages, spoiling yourself, going on trips, you know, just self-care and spoiling yourself and living a luxurious life is something that is really, really in demand on YouTube. And it will be very, very easy for YouTube to pick you, because you guys are a few, and the chances are, if people are searching that type of content, you'll be the first person to pop up and people get to see your videos. That is why I'm saying there's more demand, so the competition is not as hard. The other niche that I think can really do well is like real estate and estate stocks. I feel like a lot of people are looking on ways of multiplying their money, or should I say investment. A lot of young people there, they are already owning business and they really want to know about how they can invest their money, how can they, you know, stack up their money, you know, multiply their money, become millionaires, all the financial opportunities available. I feel like if you have so much knowledge about estate investment, I'm not saying start a skim people channel here, I'm saying if you have knowledge, you can actually start a channel around that and teach people how you can invest your money, and teach people, don't take people's money, okay? Teach people on how you can invest money and how you can really hop onto this investment stock thing and everything. I feel like there's really, really more demand of that, and people are looking for investment opportunities, how to go about it, how to start about it. And if I think of somebody who does a channel which does investment, and a Financial Bunny is a South African YouTuber, she really does a good work, and literally she's the only person that comes to my mind. And she doesn't even cover most of the stuff about, you know, real estate and everything. She is more sided onto investment, and you can really see how there's so much demand and a lot of content to be done and so much to be filmed and so much to be teaching people. So I feel like this is one of the best niches that you can hop onto. The other one that I want to talk about is tutorials. Specifically, I want to focus on food. When it comes to food, especially us Southern African, I feel like West African, they are really doing a good job, because they are a very, there are a lot of channels which show people how to cook fufu, how to cook their lovely food. But I feel like for us in Southern Africa, I can't think of any channel really, except for Instagram. There are a lot of Instagrammers who does the content around that, and they really cook amazing food. But when it comes to YouTube, I'm not saying they're not there, they might be there, but literally I can't think of anyone. That's how scarce they are there on YouTube. So I feel like this is like a gap that needs to be filled. So if you're really a good cook and you want to start a YouTube channel, this is actually a great idea that you can actually explore and see how you go with it. I also think it's a good idea because you can actually do it while running your business, you know, opening your catering business and, you know, showing people how to cook, sharing recipes, sharing those amazing meals with people. And I feel like you can make like double income from your business and from YouTube. The other niche that I feel like it's fast growing is fitness. Since we've been in pandemic lockdown, people want to lose weight without actually going to gym. People want more knowledge. As I said, people are now getting into self-care. People want to be snatched. Everyone want to look their best. Everyone want to be healthy. Everyone want to reach their 40s while they still look young. So I feel like if you're onto fitness, this is a very fast growing niche that you can get into, because you can show people tutorial and actually work with people on how to do this thing. And like I said with the food channel, I know a lot of people who are doing that in Instagram, but when it comes to YouTube, I can't think of anyone who does that. I can only think of a few people who do that, and you can really see how there's still more demand on YouTube. So I feel like when you get onto this YouTube thing, we really need to start thinking like a business. Think of it as a demand, and your competitors, people who are already doing it, and what you are bringing on the table which is different, what is gonna make people to watch your content more than they're watching Mithlali's content, you know? What are you improving? You have to think of it as a business. Don't just say, oh, everyone is vlogging. Sometimes vlogging, if you don't have the personality for it, it doesn't work. And there are a lot of people who are doing vlogs there. So are you gonna stand out? So I want you guys to think of it as a business, and our YouTube viewers and subscribers as a demand. So think of the gaps the same way you are thinking about business. You are thinking, what do people need? You are thinking of solutions that you can bring to people. And if you really want to do something which is already been done, you are most likely to think, how am I going to change it? How am I going to change it? And how am I going to do it better? So those are the niches that I wanted to share with you guys. If I can think of any, I'll definitely link them on the description box. And if they are not there in the video, so check the description box. And if you know of any niche that you think is fast growing, comment down below so that we can share and grow together. And I hope you enjoyed this video. And please don't get me wrong, I'm not saying it's a very bad thing to do beauty or to do vlogs if you really think you are cut out for it, and if you have confidence that, and if you are confident that YouTube is gonna pick up your channel easily, go ahead and do it. And be well, guys. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. There are more videos that are coming. I'm gonna be talking about a few things on this new channel of mine. So thank you guys for watching, and be well.